Android is changing, and it's changing in a big way. Now, I know Android 15 is still some time away, but there's a new update that shows you how Android is going to look like in the future. Spoiler alert, if you thought smartphones have hit the peak, a new wave is coming. Look, I'm talking about the new major update for the Pixel phones, and the interesting part is this update brings features that will eventually arrive on all Android phones, and it's going to change Android forever, be it the new repair mode, the ability to use your phone as a webcam, or more importantly, the new Gemini AI integration. Now, I know you're wondering, what's Gemini AI? How is this different than Bard? See, for every AI tool, there's an AI model that is the brains behind the AI tool. For example, ChatGPT is the AI tool we use, and GPT here is the AI model that's the brains behind it. Similarly, the Gemini AI model is the brains, and Bard is the AI tool that's using the Gemini AI now. But what makes this even more interesting is that a version of the Gemini AI model is coming to Android, and this is now live with the new update on the Pixel 8 Pro, and Google has confirmed that this will come to all Android devices. I mean, this is a new AI Code app which you'll see in the app list, and to use the new AI features, you have to enable this Enable AI Code Persistent setting, which will take up some RAM from the phone for the AI computations, because all of this will work on device, no internet or info sent to the cloud. Just imagine the possibilities of Android with a powerful AI like this integrated all across the system. To give us a trailer, they've already integrated this into Gboard with Smart Replies. So I can go to a WhatsApp conversation and you can see Gboard suggesting you replies based on the conversation. Sure, right now it only seems to suggest simple responses, but it's AI, so it should get better over time and it will be useful. Also, right now, this is only working in WhatsApp, but since this is part of Gboard, it should work in all apps sooner or later. Another cool feature is in the Recorder app. I mean, the Google Recorder already has some of the coolest features, but now if you like have a long recording, you can go to the Transcript tab and hit Summarize, and it will give you bullet points, making it much easier to, you know, get the gist of the meeting. I know there are third-party apps already doing this, but the fact that this is built right into Android is the cherry on the top. Sure, the Recorder is exclusive to Pixel phones, but this is just a trailer. Google has confirmed that they will be integrating the Gemini AI model to more Google apps, be it Google Maps, Google Chrome, or Search, and Bard with the new Gemini AI model will also arrive on Android. I mean, just imagine asking Google Maps one single question to plan a road trip for you with a route according to your preferred restaurants, hotels, with your specified budget in mind. How easy that will be. Now, it's not just the Gemini AI. This new update brings a repair mode for Android smartphones. I mean, I remember making a video on the one Samsung feature that needs to be copied. It was about Samsung's maintenance mode. And well, Google has finally heard us. This update brings a repair mode to Pixel phones. And this is super useful at times when you're giving your phone to your service center and you don't want your data to be, you know, accessible to others. Now, in the repair mode, you get the stock apps and you have access to camera settings, but your Google accounts are gone. All of your personal data is gone, be it from the Files app or Google Photos. There's also a Pixel Diagnostics app that can be used by the service center staff to, you know, run tests on the phone. What's also interesting is that when you restart your phone in the repair mode, the phone again goes into the repair mode, and to exit the repair mode, you'll have to enter your PIN or PAT. Now, this is good, but I would have liked if Google had brought unlimited backup for the phone for a limited time like, you know, Samsung does. Anyway, another feature from this update that I can see making its way to all Android phones is the ability to use your Android phone as a webcam, and I love how seamlessly this works. All you need to do is connect your phone to a PC or a Mac with a cable, yeah, it works on both, and just select webcam in the USB preferences, and that's it. You can even configure the webcam to use the front camera or the rear camera. You can even choose from the main lens or the ultra wide angle lens. And yeah, this is limited to 1080p, but still better than most useless webcams. There's also a lot more cool features in this update, like the ability to remove stain from documents when scanning a document in Google Drive. You can also restrict screen recording to a single app so no notifications or other details are captured. You can also see the battery manufacture date and cycle count next to Android version in the settings. Look, I'm expecting most of these features to arrive in all Android phones by next year, but what I'm truly excited about is the Gemini AI integration in Android. I know right now the integration is very basic. It's basically an example of what it can do, but with Google planning to integrate it in more apps and the fact that they've opened up the Gemini AI models to developers and manufacturers makes me believe that we are going to see a wave of AI phones this year. Mark this date, there is going to be a new wave. We have had a wave every year, a wave of big screen phones, phones with dual cameras, phones with notches, 5G phones. Well, 2024 is going to be all about AI smartphones. I think makers will finally make use of the crazy amount of RAM we have in high-end phones and the high-end capabilities of chipsets like the new 8 Gen 3. And honestly, I have big expectations. What about you? Comment down below and thanks for watching.